Hi guys, it's Huff. I am back again. Today I am going to be doing my makeup look for the Gotta Glam Them All collaboration with the Geeks and Beauties, which is a Pokemon themed collaboration. I missed the last 2 months. I was going to do Clink Clang last month, but never got around to it. The type for this month is water, so I had to do Magikarp because Magikarp. Everybody's got to do Magikarp at least once. So this is going to be an orange eye look, orangey, reddy eye look. There will be some white in it. So I've done my eyebrows because I'm going to be using really bright colours. I haven't done my base makeup yet. We'll do that afterwards. So I will zoom in so that we can start on the eyes. So first up, I am going to prime my eyelids. I had done this last time I did a video like this, but not today. I'm just using the Pro Primer in Nude from LA Colors or LA Girl or whatever it is. LA Girl. They're the same company. They're kind of like I Heart Revolution and Revolution Beauty, and those ones that have all got the same name, but all got part of the same name. All the same company. So spread that out. I'm actually going up higher than I usually do, which is something I've started doing a bit more of, going up to my brow bone. And a little bit under my eyes. It's kind of warm here today. We are in summer proper now. Even though it won't make up its mind and decide whether it actually wants to be summer or not. I'm just going to set that with some Balance from my Revolution Ultimate Neutrals pigment palette, which I showed in a recent unboxing. Sort of the same kind of colour as the primer. Maybe a bit more colour than the primer. And I'm not being very careful with it or anything, I'm just setting the primer down so that I can blend on top of it more easily. Okay, to start with, I'm going to go with, from the same palette, I'm going to go with Serene, which is this one here, which has kind of got a orangey tone to it. These palettes are pretty powdery. So start that. This is more just a base colour to blend over. Not trying to go too crazy. Supposed to be leaving the house today. You can hear lots of noises in the background. I've told you before, this is a working household. There's people doing stuff. It happens to be Saturday morning, so there are people cleaning and stuff like that. So I actually really like that color. It's really pretty. I haven't really played much with these palettes, so. I haven't had them that long and haven't been wearing makeup much. Okay. So now I am going to go into my Girly Cosmetics palette, and I'm going to use the orange, which I believe is called Tangerine Twist, It's a very bright orange. It has a bit of glitter in it. But that's okay. Just gonna put that in the same general area, just not blow it out quite so far. It's looking very pink to me at the moment. Alright, so I'm going to go into Circus from the Revolution Metallic Crush Pigment Palette, if I can get it open. Circus. I'm going to just gonna see what that looks like on the eyelid. Often find with metallic eyeshadows, you either need to wet them or apply them with a finger in order for them to go on. Brush doesn't tend to work as effectively as you'd like it to. Actually going to go into Demon, I think. Hang on, let me just check what else I've got. Actually, no, I'm not going to go into Demon. I'm going to go into I actually had a matte orange in here and I forgot. Going to go into Love is Love from Pretty Sweet Face, which is a red. Just want to deepen up the crease and outer corner a little bit. So this is Love is Love here. I also have this one here, which is Kiki. Pretty sure Love is Love is from the Pride collection that Pretty Sweet Face did. My brush is not totally clean. Thank you. blend that with some Kiki. Some glitter glue, and I'm going to use some glitter, because I have some great orange glitter from Glam. I'm going to use that. So just picked the eyeshadow up underneath. That looks great. Yep. Just gonna give that a second to get a tacky. This glitter is called Fire Eater. And it's basically gold and orange and gold. Just need to wet my brush a bit so it can pick it up. So I normally apply glitter glue with a brush, so then you've got a brush with glitter glue on it. But I didn't do that. I just used setting spray, if you're wondering what I used. I'm just going to press that into the glitter glue. You don't want to brush it, because you don't want it going everywhere. Ended up with glitter glue higher than I wanted it because I opened my eyes. But one needs to open one's eyes to be able to see what one is doing. Is very, very glittery. Okay, I am going to do my base makeup and then I'm going to finish my eyes. So, underneath the eyes, I think I am going to go with... Because I haven't really done any yellow. I haven't done any white, so I might do some yellow. I go with brocade from the Revolution. Metallic, actually, no. I'm going to go with Flare from Pretty Sweet Face. And I'm going to take a small brush. And first of all, I'm going to take some white eyeliner and put white eyeliner underneath my eye area. So I want to give the eyeshadow something to group onto. And bring that all the way across. This is not the whitest of whites. I've got crusty on the corner of my eye again. If you're wondering what this is Soft White from BYS, which is a brand that you can get here in Australia. So it's not like a stark white, it's quite softly, almost an off-white kind of colour. It's also picking up orange off my face. Which is why you do things like have a makeup wipe handy. So that you can clean it off. So I'm going to take a small brush. It's actually the same brush I used for the glitter. I've just cleaned it off. Going into Flare. Flare is quite a... I'm going to have to wet my brush. Flare is like a pressed pigment glitter thing. Not quite as well as I'd like, but okay. I wonder. Pick some way better on your finger. That I have a very shiny under eye. The good thing something about that particular eyeshadow that's kind of got like flaky bits in it, so it kind of looks like a fish scale thing. And in the corner of my eye, if I can locate it, I am going to put some of Lexington from Glamadolize, which is white. If I can get it open. Slightly shimmery light, which is good for things like inner corner highlights. Now, normally I would use a black eyeliner, but today I am not going to. Today I am going to use my Maybelline Colour Show in Colorista, which is kind of an orange. I don't know how well it's going to work over. I don't know how well you're going to be able to see it. Just on the bit in the middle here. Mainly because red against your eyes can look a little unpleasant. For mascara, I am using, I didn't bring my eyelash coiler over and I'm not going to go grab it. I'm going to use Lash Paradise or Lash Ecstatic, as, or Paradise Ecstatic as it is called in Australia. On the bottom lashes, I'm going to use a Clock Crusher like I normally do. It'll help give the eye a bit of definition because the white kind of takes that away. These ones don't have names. Do a fish face. I mean, it is Magikarp, so. Dogs outside doing push-ups on the lawn. That's what it looks like. She's kind of like half dragging herself but not moving anywhere. A bit like a baby who's trying to work out how to get up on its knees. And now she's gone back to sleep. So I exercise for the day. For a highlighter, I was trying to find my galactic highlighter and couldn't find it from Pretty Sweet Face. So I'm going to use a Twilight Tint from NYX, which has nothing to do with Magikarp. I just happen to like the fact that it's not champagne. The shimmery, glittery thing under my eye is so pretty. Yes, I like highlighter. Yes, I use a lot of highlighter. No, I don't care. It's going to zoom in so you can see under the eye a bit better. Kind of glittery and shimmery. I like that. It's pretty. Okay, I'm going to put on another coat of Paradise Ecstatic. Now, for lips, I decided to go sort of a pinky, nude kind of shade. Mainly because Magikarp actually has kind of pink lips. So, that's my reasoning. I am filling in with Rosewood from Satin, which is like a super budget brand. But Rosewood is one of my favourite lip liners. It's kind of this My Lips But Dead kind of colour, which I think is great. Just before I put on lipstick, I'm actually going to use my setting spray, which I'm currently using the Astralis Makeup Finishing Mist. Which I don't know if it actually makes my makeup last longer, but it smells like rose water, and I like that. So I don't like strong rose scents, but rose water's fine. You see my cute kitty on my fan? I have multiple fans because I get hot, especially in summer. Yeah. forehead's all shiny. So for my lip colour, I am using Laguna Beach from Ofra, which I got ages ago in a lip monthly, and I haven't had lip monthly for a long time. And I have multiple lip colours. This colour, this just happened to be the one I grabbed. So that is it. This is my Magikarp inspired makeup look with very glittery eyelids. I think it's fun. It's not over the top, but it's not boring either. But yeah, so this is actually the last one of these for this year. Don't forget to check out the other girls who are linked down below and see what they create for this month. And hopefully we will be doing something along the same lines next year, but just a different so something like Marvel characters or something like that. We'll be doing something different next year, but we will be doing a similar kind of monthly makeup look collab inspired by something pop culture. So if you have enjoyed this video and you would like to, please subscribe and then hit the bell if you want to get notifications. Leave me a thumbs up if you like Pokemon or Pokemon inspired videos. And leave me a comment down below. If you ask me a question, I'll try to answer it. And otherwise, I will at least like your comment. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya!